All right, come on, Yub. We're about to start. Yub? Yub Nub? Where is he? Oh, well. Hi, folks. I'm Matt, and welcome to My Expanding Universe, a show where I go through the entire EU in chronological order. What the? How did you get in here? Well, this is kind of weird. We have a gremlin with us today. Huh. Hey, speaking of weird, let's talk about the newest novel I'm going to review, The Crystal Star by Vonda M. McIntyre. In this book, Jaina, Jason, and Anakin are kidnapped. Oh no, not again! And so Leia is going after them. Now, she comes across a group of slaves, frees them, finds out that Lord Heather is the one responsible for kidnapping her children. And basically, he's been kidnapping a lot of Force-sensitive children. He's trying to find one that's really strong in the Force. Because if he finds one that's strong in the Force, well, wait for it, okay? So, we go over to Luke, Han, and 3PO, and they are going to someplace called Cray Station. I believe that's how you pronounce it. And they're all incognito because, of course, everyone knows who they are, right? And I cannot remember. I want to say that 3PO was red, but then I get this and Shadows of the Empire all mixed up. I remember one had a beard. I want to say it was Han, but they're all dressed a little bit differently. That was kind of cool. Near Cray Station is a crystal star, which has a weird effect on the Force and is making Luke all weird. And by the way Luke is written does not feel like Luke Skywalker, the one we know at least. Now, just like the expanded universe, they go ahead and just kind of do a little retcon and saying, well, that's because, you know, Calistia just left him. He's bummed at this point, you know, and that's why he felt all weird and sad and different. I don't know. Even Han makes a thing. Han says, you know, the kid's acting a little bit strange, you know, but it's the crystal star, giving out its weird, kooky Force rays. I don't know. They never explain this. Anyway, in this book, we actually come across some new alien species we never heard of before. Ghostlings. Ghostlings are attracted to humans. They're like pale versions of us, but they're very brittle. And so even like if we grip their wrist really tight, you can bruise them. If any of us could, if we just went like that, we could probably snap their bones or whatever. But yet they're attracted to humans. Like one of them's like, hello, Han Solo. He's like, yeah, I'll kill you. What are you doing? So Ghostlings is a neat idea, I guess. It was explored later on, but chronologically, it was a long time ago. Dave Wolverton explored this idea of Ghostlings where Anakin has to free the Ghostling children. I reviewed that, 2 years ago? But so that's where he got the idea for Ghostlings. So chronologically, we've already seen them before, but this is the first time publication-wise we ever heard of them. I thought Ghostlings were a neat idea. I wish we could have seen a Ghostling character maybe go throughout the series because, you know, maybe they have to be, you know, Luke has to protect her because she can, you know, even the slightest bump can bruise or break something with her. So, you know, fragile little human society or species, that's kind of neat to think about. And the other one she invented was werewolves. Yep, werewolves, because why not? Okay, but I'm not even getting to the best part here, okay? The best part is that Luke is there because he hears there's some Jedi activity going down on Cray Station, and he wants to investigate. Well, come to find out, what's going on is there's this interdimensional meat cube covered in golden scales that if you give him a sacrifice, everyone worships him. He's called Waru, and you worship him, and he will heal you or sometimes kill you. I mean, you just got to roll the dice with this guy, really. I mean, he looks like a six-sided die, so you basically just roll the Waru and see what happens. Not making this up. Meat gelatinous cube with gold scales. Is this even sounding like Star Wars? Okay, anyway, Lord Heather has kidnapped the kids because he's trying to find someone who is strong in the Force to sacrifice to Waru. Because on top of being able to heal or kill people, Waru can also induce someone with Force powers, like super-duper Force powers. And so he's promised him, Waru said, I'll give you super-duper Force powers if you feed me a child that's strong in the Force. Why? That doesn't matter. Anyway, so they're seeing Waru. Luke and Han know something's up. And then, of course, it's all going to come to a head where Lord Hether's not going to deliver the kids in time. The kids are going to escape. And Waru's going to eat Lord Hether and then disappear from our dimension forever and go back to his dimension. I wish I was making this up. So what do I think about this book? Wow. I remember when I first read The Crystal Star, this is one of the most hated books in the expanded universe by fans, generally speaking. And yeah, it's a pretty bad book. A lot of it is not very good. You're like, oh no, another kidnapping scheme. Oh no, another dark Jedi. Oh no, a Waru. A Waru? What? You know, and it's just kind of weird. Where do you get these ideas? And it fell flat. It fell flat big time. You're just like, wait, it's from another dimension? What is going on here? Is this Star Trek? And the whole time you're reading it, that's what you're thinking. Like, man, this is a weird Star Trek episode. It's funny you should say that, because Vondann McIntyre is a Star Trek author. In fact, that's why Lucasfilm got her to write a book, because they thought, if you write Star Trek, you must write good Star Wars. And they didn't understand that Star Trek and Star Wars, though being science fiction, are very rapidly different. They're very different. They're not even the same. And so, to be honest, before you start complaining, they never should have done that. Well, guess who else was a Star Trek writer? A.C. Crispin. A.C. Crispin did a great job because she got with Kevin J. Anderson. She said, let me understand the Star Wars universe. Vondann McIntyre, to my knowledge, didn't do that at all. She went, okay, I'll write something else. And she wrote this weird story that really didn't mesh well with the rest of the expanded universe. In fact, it does feel like an alternate universe where this takes place. It really does, because like I said, the characters don't sound or feel like the characters. It's like maybe Vondann McIntyre watched the movies once, but obviously she didn't read the books or didn't confer with anyone. She just made her own little weird, wild story about a crystal star. I don't remember if we ever find out why it had a weird effect on the Force or what the weird effect was. Or maybe it was just Waru, I think, was intended. But whatever happened there, it's never mentioned again in any other expanded universe novel. They never say, hey, what about Waru? Even Del Rey, who tied in every single, you know, story from the Bantam era, was like, Crystal Star? Skip. You know, they're not doing that one. So it's just a weird story. It doesn't make any sense. I think for one moment, Luke has to dive into Waru to stop him from consuming someone. I don't know. It's really strange. It's really weird. There's too many weird things to talk about that happened in the Crystal Star. Now, at the same time, this is our first on their own adventure with Jason, Jaina, and Anakin. So that's kind of neat. I mean, Kevin J. Anderson in Jedi Academy Trilogy, he had a side story in one of the novels with Jason and Jaina, which was nice, but not that much. This one gives us a little bit more. You know, they meet some other kids who are captured and everything. I don't know. There's really nothing good to say about this. Now, here's the funny thing. Out of all the bad novels, where does this one rank for me? It's not number one. I'll be honest with you. It's probably lower down on the list, like six or seven, you know. I mean, to be honest, it's not the absolute worst novel. I think there are worse novels than this. In fact, rereading it again, I think maybe I could appreciate a few other things from it. But when it first came out, you were having hit after hit after hit after hit. And then Crystal Star came out, you're like, ooh, let's try something else. So should you try Crystal Star? Yeah, I think you should, because it's just so weird. It's like, if anyone remembers me reviewing Alan Moore's Star Wars comic books, they were just so weird and out there. That is the equivalent of a Vondann McIntyre story here, is Crystal Star. It's kind of like that Alan Moore just out there, the what-if stuff, the weird stuff, so to speak. Oh, man, I'm getting thirsty. Hold on just a minute here. Oh, whoa. I'm sorry, dude. I got some on you. It's okay if I get you wet, right? That doesn't do anything bad, does it?
Dadgummit. We'll see you next time with another video.